here for myself. I don't want nobody else to love me. You are the shining star, my guiding light, my love fantasy. It's not a minute of a night that I don't really love you. You're at the top of my love, I'm always thinking of you. I still remember when the days when I was scared to touch you. How I spent my days dreaming, planning how to say I love you. You must have known that I had feelings deep enough to swim in. That's when you opened up the door and told me to come in. Oh my girl.
Open the dance floor.
Open the dance floor.
아니야. 너 인터뷰.
여기요.
Reception of Mr. and Mrs. Flowers, and the setting is beautiful. Enjoying the tamales.
Nice.
All right. Nice. Cool. All right.
You dad.
And
so hard we find you.
Quota to be your lawful wedded wife, to live together after God's ordinance in holy seat of matrimony.
I do.
Make sure you say
hi. I do.
No one can.
Yeah.
Do you love her and comfort her, honor and keep her in sickness and in health, and forsaking all others, keeping only unto her as long as you both shall live?
I do.
Any Martin Hunter, will you take Justin Nathaniel Flowers to be your lawful wedded husband, to live together after God's ordinance in holy state of matrimony?
I do.
Do you love him and comfort him, honor and keep him in sickness and in health, and forsaking all others, keeping only unto him as long as you both shall live?
I do.
All right, I'll ask you to repeat after me now. Again, we start with Mr. Flowers. I call upon
these persons here present
to witness that
I, Justin Nathaniel Flowers,
take thee in it, Martha Clotter.
To be my lawful wedded wife.
To have and to hold. From this day forward.
For better, for worse.
For richer or poorer. In sickness and in health. To love and to cherish. Till death do us part. According to God's holy ordinance.
And thereto,
I give you
my pledge.
I call upon
these persons here present
to witness
that I, Enid Martha Clotha,
take thee, Justin Nathaniel Flowers. To be my lawful wedded husband.
To have and to hold.
From this day forward. For better, for worse.
For richer, for poorer.
In sickness and in health.
To love and to cherish.
Till death do us part. According to God's holy ordinance. And thereto I give you my pledge. What token do you have as an exchange of these vows? The rings you're using this morning as an exchange of these vows, been used for decades as a symbol of marriage, the union, made of gold. And somebody went perhaps to the chicken bone and panned for gold. And then what they found, they had another degree in it. So they had to take it to a goldsmith and they put a torch on it and they burn out all the debris. So what we have this morning is pure gold, solid gold. And you're going to be wearing these rings as you leave here today. But as you do, they will remind you of a solemn message that when you come into your difficulties and your problems in life and don't know what to do, you look at the ring. And let the ring remind you that your union is more precious than silver and gold. So that as the gold went through the fire by the goldsmith and remained pure gold, so that when your union goes through the fire, you will come out as a pure relationship that God intended for you. But then look at it also, and it doesn't have an end. It suggests to us that the union will not come to an end. And let the ring remind you, when you want to play that tape recorder back to see yourself walking on free people, let the ring remind you there is no end, and therefore you stay committed. But these rings also will serve as a deterrent A deterrent because as the girls look at Justin, they must admire what a handsome guy he is. And they would want a piece. And Justin, you just don't even have to answer, you just hold up your hand so that they will see the ring.
Flush it.
Flush the ring.
And when they see the ring, they will say, ah.
Back off.
And the smile that in it has, oh my goodness. Yes, yes, yes. And the ladies have a way of flinging their fingers.
Ah.
Let them see the ring. And when they see that, they will know, I better go elsewhere. So this ring, you're going to wear it proudly, and it has a lot of significance to you, staying together, dead to the spot. I'm going to ask you now to put your ring halfway on your finger. I give you this ring.
I give you this ring.
As a token,
as a token
of the covenant.
Of the covenant.
Made between us this day.
Made between us this day.
And as a pledge.
As a pledge.
Of our mutual.
Our mutual.
Love.
Love.
And satisfaction.
And satisfaction.
In the name of the Father.
Of the Father.
And of the Son.
Of the Son.
And of the Holy Spirit. I give you this ring.
I give you this ring.
As a token.
As a token.
Of the covenant.
Of the covenant.
Made between us this day.
Made between us this day.
And as a pledge.
And as a pledge.
Of our mutual.
Of our mutual.
Love and satisfaction.
Love and satisfaction.
In the name of the Father.
In the name of the Father.
And of the Son.
And of the Son.
Of the Holy Spirit.
Of the Holy Spirit.
As the union is now formed, it becomes you to consider the vows that you have received and have given each other. And if you remain faithful to these vows, you will experience the kind of happiness and satisfaction that God intended for a man and a woman as they join themselves together. But if you become unfaithful to these vows, you will not escape the tedious misery that comes as a result of unfaithfulness to the bow. Put your hands together. Let us pray. Our God and our Father, we thank you for creating this school and for bringing them together in your divine plan for marriage and the covenant that you have caused them now to be a part of. Father, commit them into your hands. Pray that your Holy Spirit will form a hedge of protection around them, and that Satan will have no say in this union. But God, they will draw from you each day the strength that they need, the wisdom, and that you will provide for them spiritually, physically, emotionally, on all the needs that they have. I pray, Father, that as they commit themselves to you, that indeed you will keep them under your wings and protect them from the wiles of the devil. We commit them into your hands now and pray your will upon their lives. In Jesus' name.